Chill Mama and Chill Love shows. And we're here with the Flying Steps today.
That's right.
And your show is Flying Bach.
Yeah, that's
it. So have any of you been in Chicago before, or is this first?
First time. That's the first time with Red Bull Flying Bach to be here in the States. And yeah, the first stop is Chicago. And yeah, we are really exciting to come in June. And yeah, so now we are here to doing some promotion stuff and doing some workshops. So it's very important for us to come together with the scene and show the people what we are doing in Europe. And yeah, so we are looking forward.
Absolutely. Now, if you'd like to just start very quickly and say your name and what you do.
Yeah.
Okay, my name is Casey Wan. I'm 27, dance like 13 years. Yeah.
And you're a b-boy.
I'm b-boy, yeah.
I'm Anna, and I'm dancing contemporary in this project.
My name is Michael, and yeah, that's it.
Yeah, my name is Li Chang, and I'm 22 years old, and I dance 12 years now, b-boy.
Okay, excellent. Now, the three of you are from Berlin,
yeah.
Boys, the breakdancers, yeah?
Yeah, we're from Berlin, and
I'm from Sweden.
And you're from Sweden,
yeah.
And you come from a ballet background?
Yeah, ballet, classical and contemporary. I'm a contemporary dancer.
Now, how did you guys end up hooking up? How did a Swedish ballerina and dancers from Germany end up hooking up on a project?
Something.
Yeah, well, I was not in the project from the beginning. The project started in 2010, and I joined the crew since June last year. But I auditioned a couple of years ago, and
yeah.
we exchanged contacts, but I didn't get the part then. And then they were looking for a new girl, and I actually did the promotion for them in Sweden when they were there. And suddenly we started talking, and
yeah.
Now we're here.
Yeah.
And you've never been to Chicago
no.
before either?
No.
Oh, yeah. Very cool. Yeah, I was pretty excited. I'm actually back a few generations, but I'm half Swedish, half German.
Oh,
so,
no,
I did this interview. Fantastic. And I haven't been to Germany. My sister studied there
yeah.
in Freiburg for a half a year.
Freiburg. Okay.
But I've been to Sweden twice.
Oh, okay. Which?
Yeah. So nice. Welcome. Do you get to see anything in Chicago while you're here? Or do they have you pretty busy?
Yeah.
We've been busy.
A lot of
busy.
Stuff
yeah.
to do,
yeah.
so we see not so much, but I know you were shopping, eh?
Yes,
so
I was.
This guy too, so
yeah.
yeah. But we are looking forward when we come in June, then we have some more days off, and then
a little bit more time.
Much, much more.
And hopefully to get a feel it's a little bit warmer
yeah.
as well.
Yes. Yeah, oh,
definitely. At least you got a little bit of sun today.
Yeah.
So, so who works on your choreography?
So, Flying Steps, working together on the choreography.
Okay.
When we start with this, and you know, Flying Steps is very popular for that we're doing not a normal b-boy show or breakdance show.
Yes, exactly.
So we are looking every time forward to find new things. So one day, the idea of Vatan, one of the owners from Flying Steps, was let's try something with classic music. And we said,
right. And so you choreographed to Bach, right?
Yeah. So we was like, okay, let's try. So. But you know, we are not from this side, so we don't know exactly how we can start with this project. So we are looking around and find Christoph Hagel. He's the art director now of this project. And we met him and tell him about our idea. And he's looking forward, but he don't know exactly what's happened with breakdance, you know?
Right.
So we invite him to one of our shows. And after this, he was really happy and said, it's a really nice thing what you do. You have a lot of energy. And I give you a call.
Wow.
Okay. So we wait, and 2 weeks later he gave us a call and said straight, hey, you know what? You dance to Johann Sebastian Bach.
Wow.
So we was like, okay, why not? So we trust him, you know?
Yeah,
so
for sure.
That's why. And yeah, he was really right with this, and then we work on it. So he explained us the music, and yeah, in the beginning it was hard to listen to it, you know?
Uh-huh.
So we are from the hip-hop side.
Right,
from the
so
scene,
something totally different
completely
for you.
Different music, and yeah, but at some pieces of the music, we have straight ideas to fix the choreographies and have good steps to work on it.
Mm-hmm.
And then some pieces we was really like, okay, now we are in trouble, you know.
Hard to.
So yeah, hard work. So yeah, but then it works. So, but it was not enough, so we are not the first one who are dancing on classic music mm-hmm. as a hip-hop group, you
but
know?
But it's a really interesting mashup. I don't think there are a lot of people out there doing that. Now, yeah. you're four times world champion breakdancers.
Yeah, that's right.
What do you dance to when you compete for the world?
Oh, then we
what
choose
are they
by
yeah.
music by ourselves, and it's really a mix of everything. So we are really open with our mind about the music, but most of the things are a mix of break beats and funk music, the old stuff
old
from the
folk.
60s and 90s, 70s. So
you said like old school funk and stuff
yeah.
too?
Funk, old school.
So what's, I always like to ask people, what's on your iPod when you're not performing? You know, what do you listen to just on your own personal time?
Clement, ASAP.
Yeah. New stuff, right?
Yeah, new stuff.
Yeah.
So it's completely different, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So do you have any particular influences, like favorite bands or genres, styles?
Yeah, we like, I mean, I like more the old school, like back in the days, the music, like Run DMC, NWA, or like, yeah, Michael Jackson for me is also really yeah. amazing. And James Brown, he too, yeah, he give us a lot of inspiration. Like this time, you know, 18th, when b-boying started, we heard it, we listened to this music, you know. It was funk music. When you go club, you know how you dance.
Right, yeah. Right. Now, did any of you just start as street dancers? I think a lot of people still even think of breakdancing as just like street, you know, street
yeah.
dancing or very
right,
like local.
Yeah, this way we try it like in Germany also like to show the people like b-boying is more like only like not only breakdance, you know, it's more popular or like more high level, you know.
Dance,
you know, this the people they think like classic or like ballet is high level, but normally b-boying too. And we show them, you know, the people, we mix it, this way we mix it and bring it
to the stage.
Exactly. Yeah. So you've made it legitimate,
and we
more
bring,
like mainstream.
I mean, we bring also the new generation and the old generation.
Yes.
I mean, the old generation, they listen to classic music.
Exactly.
And the young generation, they like the moves and boing, they love it, the kids. And it's why we win both.
Right. So now you can bring both generations, and
yes.
there's something for everybody.
Yeah. That's why I think people, they come, they look to see the show.
And it's really interesting to know when we perform, after we talk to the people from the theater, and they are really thankful for our project, why they said, you know, with our project, you bring really the young people back to the theater. So really in Germany, they have a lot of problems that nobody want to go anymore to the theaters, you
yes.
know.
Mm.
It goes more, much more away. Mm. And with this project, we bring really everybody together back to the theater and having a really good fun
mm-hmm.
for our project.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
All right. Well, get ready for teaching your class, and then we're going to roll a little bit on your teaching here. I mean, we'll encourage everybody to buy tickets and
all
show
right.
in
so
June.
We are looking really forward to perform. We are really happy that we can stay here and show the people what's happened. We wait more than 4 years to come
yeah.
to the U.S.
Oh,
yeah. So now we are here.
Nice.
Yeah.
And,
Philippe it.
Yeah, we hope everybody will like it. And yeah, come to the show and enjoy.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you so much for taking the time to meet with us.
Thank you.
All right, so you're ready for it? Yeah.